A very good morning to all of you students. This is Ishani Trivedi from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome back to the session of Building Construction Technology. In the previous sessions up to now, we discussed about the different type of building components, correct? In that, we discussed about the first, which was doors, the second was windows, the third we discussed was correct, that is stair and staircases. Now we are moving forward to the next building component, that is flooring. You can say floor, you can say floor covering, or you can say flooring. All of the three things are going to remain the same. So in all, according to your syllabus, according to your module, we are supposed to discuss about five different types of building components. Okay, so now you are clear with the staircases, the different types, how to draw its plan, its cross-sectional elevation. I suppose that you have practiced on your own that how you can draw the cross-sectional elevation and plan. And based on that, you will be also able to understand how to write down the points, the theoretical points regarding the staircase. Now we are moving forward today with the flooring. Now, what is a floor? What is a floor? So if I ask you what is a floor, then it is very much clear to you that the flat surface where we are standing, correct? You will say that see, you have floor at your home also. Without that, you will not be able to stand anywhere. Even the ground is a flat surface, right? If you step, you need something to step on. Where will you step? You will step on a flat surface. Now that flat surface is an important, it is an essential, it is mandatory component required for any kind of structure, be it commercial building or a residential building or an institutional building or even a warehouse or even a storage house or a godown or a shop or anything. You require a flat surface to step on and also to store your material, your goods. That includes your furniture, your storage equipment. If it is a warehouse, if it is a godown, then you will have lots of heavy machinery or equipment, or let us say if it is a godown for a grains. For everything you require a flat surface where we can step on, that is known as flooring. Now we are going to discuss first certain technical terms regarding the flooring concept. That what are the different terms used for different types of floor. Now if I say different type of floor, means starting from the ground level. Starting from the ground level, you will have ground floor, then you will have upper floors, then you will have a roof or a terrace, right? Now you can understand that all the upper floors shall be different from the ground floor, and the roof or the terrace will be again different from the ground floors and upper floors. You also have basement, that is your below ground level, right? So different types of flooring will vary according to the requirements, according to the situations, according to the also according to the requirement of the client because of its cost and appearance. So let us first discuss different types of technical terms related to flooring. So what do we have first over here is only the floor. What does it say? Construction of bottom of a room, right? The flat surface bottom of a room is known as floor. Now I am moving to the second type of definition. I think I have discussed the purpose now. It is already discussed right now, which we were talking about, that why the flooring is necessary and why it is required, and what are its purpose. That is to step on, to dwell on it, to live on it, to storage your to store your equipment, your goods, your furniture, your everything, right? So that is the main purpose of providing the flooring. And I think you should be able to write on your own also, because everyone knows that why a flooring is important, right? Next definition we have is ground floor. As I said, that ground floor is always different from the upper floors, right? Because ground floor will be provided just above your plinth level. It will be around 45 to 60 centimeter above the plinth level, and there starts your ground floor. So below the ground floor, you will have sand filling, muram filling, that you will have the subgrade soil, and on top of that you will carry out your flooring method, your construction process. So it will be a little bit different from the upper floors. So first you have is ground floor, which is provided at the ground level. It is a little bit above the ground level, right? You know what is a plinth. All of these things are already discussed. Okay, so next we have is upper floors. Upper floor, as I said, how it will be different, because when you deal with the upper floors, then you will also have to deal with the loads coming from the top of the structure. You will have beam, column and slab construction. You will have dead loads. You will have live loads, right? So all of those calculation will be done and the load analysis will be carried out. So upper floor will be different than the ground floor, right? It is built above the ground floor. Now, please note that I am not talking about roof right now. If we talk about upper floors, then a roof, that is also a floor, but roof will be different. So next you have is terrace. You can call it a roof, you can call it a terrace. So the topmost floor. Now what will be the difference at the topmost floor? It will be exposed to the atmosphere, right? It will be exposed to sun, wind, rain, temperature changes. If it is a cold country, then frost action. So the topmost floor, which is constructed, which will be having different courses, different layers as compared to the ground floor and upper floors, because you have to protect it from the external surroundings, because it is remaining exposed permanently, then it is your terrace or the roof. Completely we will have a concept about the types of roofing, roof and roof coverings. We will have a separate concept regarding that topic. Next you have is basement. I think you know what is a basement. I don't need to explain it in that detail. It is provided below the ground level. So it will be, if I say G plus 10, then I can say for the basement G minus 1, G minus 2, depending on the number of basement. But still, you need a floor over there because it is used for parking purpose. So dead load is going to be prominent. Also the live load, because the vehicles will be moving. Vehicles will also cause the impact load. Right, you know about the highway pavement construction also. So your bottommost floor below the ground level will be your basement. Next you have is Barsati. Now see, this is you can say this, it is also Hindi or in regular local language word, and this is also English word, because it is one and the same in both the cases. What is a Barsati? So what does it say? It is the roof constructed on terrace to protect against the rain. So you have a terrace, you have the topmost floor, but on top of that, the element, the structural member which is constructed, that is called roofing, and that particular roof which is provided to protect your surface from the rain, specifically from the rain, the course which is provided is known as Barsati. Now have a look at the image flashing over here on top of me. You can see that on the roof, on the terrace, you can see another cabin is built. Can you see that? Another cabin is built. So now this cabin which is built on the roof, on the terrace, so on, see, this is ultimately your staircase cabin, right? Because you will need a staircase to go to the terrace, to the roof, right? So you will have to provide a staircase cabin, okay? So where it ends, okay? Or let us say sometimes you will also have a small storage kind of room. So ultimately this cabin and the cabin on which the top floor is constructed, that means the roof which is constructed on the staircase cabin, is known as Mumti. It is a technical name, it is also a local language name, so you will have to always call it as Mumti. Next you have is loft. What is a loft? Now look at the second image flashing over here. Can you see that on top, on the top side near the ceiling, storages are provided? You can see that small cupboards are provided. Can you see that? Now, it is not always necessary that you have provided doors to the storages, to the cupboards. It may be open space also. So the storage space provided just near the ceiling, right? Just near the ceiling. I'm sure if you have a look in your room right now, you would be having this storage space where all of your materials and junk and everything you are going to store. So that space is known as loft. Okay, whenever you are constructing a loft, when you are providing the slab, it is necessary to take into account your immediate floor above, that is your ceiling, right? So that makes your next or last definition known as loft. Now moving forward to the basic concepts, and then we shall take about the different types of classification of the flooring. Now, first of all, what are the major components of a flooring? I think you should be able to speak in your mind also that we will have a sub-base course, we will have a base course, and the final finishing will be the flooring. Correct. But we will divide them into two parts. We will have a sub-base layer, and second we will have the topmost, that is the flooring. In between you can provide many courses. You can provide a base course, you can provide lime concrete, cement concrete. You also have damp proof course. Sometimes see if you see the image flashing above me, then you can see that lots of intermediate courses are provided. So that depends on the requirement. The image which you can see over here is for a ground floor, right? Also you can say that for the highway pavement, you have the soil subgrade, then you have the sub base, then you have base course, and then you have finishing layer, right? Similarly over here you can see that you have the subgrade, soil subgrade if you are talking about the ground floor. Proper filling will be done with the sand and the mural, and then you will have a sub base course. Can you see that gravels are provided? So now this happens in case of a pavement, right? Because you have to drain off the water, seepage of water takes place in that case. Here you can provide damp proof course or any other waterproofing courses, you can provide that. Then comes a layer, sub base layer, that is made up of lime concrete or cement concrete. Okay, so that becomes your binder material. Binder material for what? For laying the flooring. Now flooring can be of different types. It can be timber, it can be tile flooring, it can be mosaic tiles, it can be ceramic tiles, it can be marble flooring. If I ask you types of flooring, then you are going to speak up one by one all types of flooring, right? But how will you fix them? How will you make them stable? How will you bind them? That is done with the help of the sub-base layer, sub-base course known as cement concrete or lime concrete or mortar. It may be combination of any. So as I said, we have the floor base, which is the lowest layer. As I said, I think this image is going to make it clear, and the same technical points are flashing over here. Then you have the second layer, that is your lean concrete. Okay, it may be lime mortar, it may be cement concrete, and then the floor finishing is laid on top of that, and that makes your flooring. Now we are moving next to the requirements of a floor. What are the essential requirements? What are the basic requirements? Okay, so we have over here a total of 5 requirements. We had also discussed for the staircase, right? There are certain requirements for locating a staircase. We had discussed about the headroom, about the rise and head. Then we had different type of that. We had about fire resistance, I had talked about the material. So similarly, if you take any building component, then each and every time you will be having certain factors which will be affecting the selection of the same, and also the points to be remembered. Now what are the points over here? First we have is adequate strength and stability. It means proper strength, right? Of course flooring will be requiring strength because you are going to live on it, right? So proper strength is definitely required, and along with the stability. If it is say weak, then you are going to fall. If it is slippery, then you are going to fall. If you provide some kind of impact load, let us say that accidentally you are dropping a heavy weight on the floor, and if it breaks, if it is not stable, then it is not desirable. Next you have is adequate fire resistance. As I had said in the staircase, that how fire resistance is important, because it will be the only means of exit for the for the users when fire takes place. So similarly, floor should also be fire resistant, because it will be the only place where the users can rely on in the worst case when fire takes place. Next you have is sound insulation, and you have is damp resistance. Sound insulation, thermal insulation and damp resistance, all three always go together. Remember when we had discussed about the cavity walls? Yes. So now floor should also be such that it should have minimum amount of dampness. That is why we provide DPC at ground floor, because moisture can enter from the soil subgrade. It should have DPC, that is your damp proof course. It should have sound insulation. Now see, if I talk about timber flooring, if you step on timber flooring, if you run on timber flooring, it is going to make noise. And as compared to your tile flooring, it will not make noise. So it should have proper sound insulation. It should make less noise, and also external sound from the bottom floor, from the bottom stories, it should not transfer easily, right? Because it is a matter of a privacy also. Then you have a thermal insulation. You should be able to keep it cool as much as possible in summer. And if I talk about marble, you know that marble becomes very cold. So when it is winter season, then marble is always going to stay cool, but it will be helpful in summer, right? So every type of flooring has its own advantage and disadvantage, but you should take care that all these requirements are fulfilled. Next, we are going to talk about the factors affecting selection. What are the factors which will affect that what type of flooring you will select? I think some of the points I already discussed in the requirements of a good floor, about marble flooring, about timber flooring. But let us be specific, let us decide the specific types of factors affecting the selection. What do you have first? First we have is initial cost. Now marble flooring is always going to be costly, as compared to brick flooring is very much cheap. Tile flooring is sometimes costlier, sometimes cheap. So it depends on the initial cost, that how much your user is going to spend. So it should have as much as minimum cost initially, so that the users can accept it. Next you have is appearance. Obviously, appearance is the most important factor. Sometimes you have glazed tiles which shine. You have glass tiles, you have ceramic tiles, you have mosaic tiles. Then there is a special type of flooring called granolithic flooring, in which different colors can be obtained. Brick flooring is not going to give a good appearance, definitely. So you can use it at places where the appearance is not important. So appearance matters when you are discussing the type of flooring. Next you have is cleanliness. Okay, it is simple that it should be able to remain clean. The impurities, the dust particles, it should not get clogged in the joints on the surface of the flooring. It is very much desirable that it can be easily cleaned. Next you have is durability. Of course, durability, because flooring is something which has to stay till the end, till the existence of the building. So durability is important. If you talk about concrete flooring, you know that concrete material has a good durability, so it will be long lasting. If you talk about marble, then that also it has a good durability. So it depends what type of flooring we select. Sound insulation, we already talked about it. I told you that timber is going to produce noise. Okay, also sound insulation, it means there should be no transfer of noise from one story to another, right? It should be having enough insulating material, sound insulating material. Thermal insulation, we already discussed, I think. And fire resistance, I said that why it is important. Concrete exhibits good fire resistant properties as compared to stone flooring, as compared to brick. Brick also exhibits good fire resistance. About stone flooring also, you know about the Kota stone, right? Flagstone. It is generally called flagstone, but it will have very poor fire resistance properties. Next you have a smoothness. Smoothness of the surface, but utmost smoothness is also not required, that you will slip on the floor. Okay, and hardness and maintenance. Hardness is definitely necessary, and maintenance should be as cheap as possible. So it should be such that you are able to maintain it, you are able to repair it very easily. It should be such kind of a material. So concluding today for this session is the classification of different types of flooring. You can see the chart flashing over here. And although in your mind you will be having all types of flooring already, it is not very much tough. We have timber flooring, we have the most common. Let us talk about the most common. We have the timber flooring, we have flagstone, that is Kota stone flooring. You have brick flooring, concrete flooring. At your houses you should be having tiled flooring. So in tiles also you have PVC tiles, you have mosaic tiles, you have ceramic tiles, lots of different types of tiles are available in the market. Then you have marble flooring. About the granolithic flooring, as I said, it is a special type of flooring which we will discuss in detail also. Granolithic or terrazzo. Terrazzo is also somewhat similar to granolithic. Both of them are quite similar. We shall discuss about that in detail in the coming sessions. Then we have marble flooring, I think cement concrete flooring. So all of these types of flooring will be discussed in detail, but with classification of ground floors and upper floors. Okay students, so I think we are done for the day with the starting with the basics of the flooring. We shall discuss further about different types of flooring in next session. Okay students, that's it for the day. Thank you.